Hello, it's Kujaif. In this video, I'll show you how to create a photocopy effect in Photoshop, reminiscent of old photocopies with their unique texture. First, upload the photo we want to turn into this effect. It is desirable to choose a high contrast image for better results. Click Filter and open Filter Gallery. We need the sketch folder. Select the reticulation filter. This filter has three types of settings. Density controls the concentration of grain or texture. A higher density makes the grain appear more prominent and packed together, while a lower density spreads it out, creating a subtler effect. Foreground level sets the brightness threshold for the grain. Higher levels make the light areas of the grain more visible and distinct, while lower levels soften the contrast of these areas. Background level adjusts the darkness of the grain in shadow areas. Higher levels make the dark grain areas more intense and pronounced, while lower levels create a softer and more faded look in the shadows. For this image, I've selected these specific settings. The next step is to add solid color and select white. Convert to smart object. Apply a filter to this layer. Back to the filter gallery. In the sketch folder, click halftone pattern. Line pattern type. Set the size to 5 and the contrast to 25. Now for this layer, select the overlay blending mode. I'm already liking the effect. Reminds me of the stripes left by a photocopier. Just a few final touches left to complete the photocopy effect. Switch to the new adjustment layer and apply the threshold effect. I set the opacity to 50% to soften the intensity. You can see how this adds a distinct texture to the image. For the existing halftone pattern filter on another layer, reduce the opacity from 100% to 60%. This helps create a more natural vintage look. Remove the threshold effect layer below the halftone layer. Changing the layer order adds extra depth and a more authentic photocopy effect. It's done. And as you can see, it perfectly captures the photocopy style with its unique texture and contrast. But if you'd like to add a bit of color, you can easily do that with a gradient map. If you want to learn more about how the gradient map works, check out my previous video where I go into more detail. That's all. We've created a vintage photocopy effect. Try different settings, add textures, and create unique looks. If you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.